Alaska Live TV. Music and conversation from the KUAC FM studio is made possible by a grant from Design Alaska. Architecture and engineering for the new frontier.
Cello Fury. Hey, thanks you guys for coming in to the KUAC studios.
Thank you for having us. We're so excited to be here.
So what are we starting off with? We have three cellos and a drummer. This is exciting.
First song we're going to play is called Tundra.
Cello Fury, that is played with some fury, and the name of that song was Tundra, which I love the name. It evokes Alaska scenery and what we experience here. It's Nicole Myers, Simon Cummings, and Ben Munoz.
Yeah.
playing cellos, and David Throckmorton back there on the drums. Simon, the name of the song is Tundra, and who wrote that one?
I wrote that one, and Ben and I are the two songwriters. We each take turns writing songs.
And you write it for the arrangement that you have of three cellos, and the drums come in on that one, and then it really takes off from there.
Yeah, definitely. We like to start out sometimes a little more on the chill side and then get everyone going with the drums.
Well, what's next? Because that was exciting, and I want another one.
Actually, a piece that Ben wrote. This is a piece called Never Done, and it's from our latest album called Symphony of Shadows.
Cello Fury, my guest today on Alaska Live. You said that Simon and Ben are the composers for the group. I mean, a lot of, you think of, like a cello crossover band. They're just going to take some Metallica and Black Sabbath songs and they're going to rock out on the cello. But what you guys do is you write songs for this group and sometimes even in more of a classical tradition.
Yeah, a lot of our songs are composed with that background, for sure, the more classical background, and we're probably the more, we're very refined in our rocking out. It's not as like, you know, raw. It's a little bit more polished up.
And you didn't put any distortion pedals on it. At least here, I don't know what you do at your shows, but you don't do that.
No, we don't. Yeah. We don't really play with any effects, really. We just amplify it and make sure it all sounds right, and then go.
And you don't do that with your recording either. And I think that that makes it just so real and raw, and just a bit more like, you know, the classical music rather than the rock music. But you definitely can rock out.
Really, when we're playing live, we tend to perform with our hair down, and we stand up, and there's a big performance aspect to it. But you can definitely tell that they're cellos, which I think is a huge part of our sound.
And so here in the studio today, the guys have their hair back. They're not whipping it around today. But
if you want to see some crazy headbanging cellists, come on out.
So, Nicole, at the shows, the guys let their hair down and they start going for it, huh?
That is correct. Yes, there's hair flying all over the place.
Well, should we do another song?
So we're going to play a piece that's a little bit different. This one's called Pins and Needles, and it's from our first album called Cello Fury. And this is an all plucking piece, so we're going to put our bows down for this one.
Thank you.
Ben, they say that you are one of the composers for the group. And so in that last one, talk about composing a little bit for how you do it for three cellos and for the drums. You have to write in leads, right? Because there has to be somebody who is playing like the melody.
Well, I mean, it's nice because writing for your own instrument, you really know what the instrument can do and what it can't do. And, you know, it's a little different from if you're having to write a flute concerto as a cellist, and you might not, the flutist might not be too happy with you. And our music all starts out as classical sheet music. I mean, if you look at it from just like an actual sheet music standpoint, that's what it looks like. There's a score and parts and everything. And we pass out the parts and have rehearsal, and then, you know, it turns into kind of the rock performance piece, you know, somewhere towards the end before we actually perform it. And what we do when Simon and I write, just because each of us has, you know, certain like strengths and a really individual voice, each of the cellists and the cellos themselves, nobody's ever stuck with the bass part. Granted, in our band, the bass parts are really fun, but they're pretty exhausting. So
they're, you know, really physical.
Yeah, and yeah. We, you know, so within a piece, you know, whoever has the melody may switch three or four times within a piece. So it's not only just for us to have a little break from, you know, the really physically taxing bass parts, but it's also a kind of a visual stimulus for the audience, just to kind of keep your eyes shifting to see who's, you know, taking on the part of the lead vocalist at any given time in a piece.
Here in the studio, even though I'm in the same studio with you, there's a lot of equipment that is blocking my views, and I find myself trying to look around it to see what's going on, because it is true that you're all passing around those leads. Do you ever experiment with somebody tuning down their cello to a different tuning?
That's actually, it's funny you mentioned that. It's kind of on the list of things to do, just because, you know, there's a real... It's such a great sound at the low end of the cello. Unfortunately, it only goes so low normally.
Right.
So if we decided to do a little bit of drop tuning, it would open up a lot of doors compositionally for different keys to use. So
and that drop tuning would mean that you would tune all the strings to be lower in the range.
I mean, it depends. You can do however you kind of want to do it. Commonly, the bottom two strings are the ones that get detuned about a half step, so G and C go down to F sharp and B. And it's a really, really great sound. It shows what the cello can really do. So it's on the list of things to try for, you know, in the near future.
Well, and I'm sure you just put out this album Shadow at Symphony of Shadows last year, but I'm sure you're already working on new material for the next one, and so that might be something to try for the next one.
Yeah, who knows? Keep your ears open. Simon and I are always writing something, and so we're just, what are we, maybe about 60-65% done with new material for the next album.
Nice.
So yeah, we're always working on it.
Nicole, are you always amazed that what they can come up with? I mean, because... here you are, and they come to practice with, this is maybe unnamed yet, but here it is.
Yeah. Sometimes the name actually changes after we've played a couple times. It's interesting. For me, it's really cool to see what they come up with. And it's, you know, as classically trained musicians, for example, if you play a Mozart piece, the composer's not in the room. So you can do your own interpretation of it. But with Ben and Simon, they wrote the piece and they're performing it. So in terms of figuring out just the subtleties that we're going to be doing dynamics and tuning and stuff and tweaking things, it's a little bit tricky because I have to speak to the composer and then also speak to the performer in the band. So they do both roles.
Well, it's nice. Unlike Mozart, you cannot have Mozart in the room with you, but you do have, in your case, the composers in the room with you.
That's right.
So... how did you end up getting a tour booked for Alaska? Because a lot of bands dream of being able to come up here, but it's not feasible all the time for a four-member band to come up.
Yeah, that's right. We played the South by Southwest Music Festival in Austin, Texas. We played it last year, but also the year before. It's the largest music festival in the country, and the music director for the state fair was there, and he really loved the show. And he started talking to us about coming to Fairbanks. And it was a little bit of a dream at that point, but we kept talking and pushing it, and it ended up that we got all of these shows booked. And the festival is really helped us out a lot with the logistics of getting here, but we did have to fundraise to fly our cellos out. So when we traveled, we had 7 seats, and it's really tricky because they're very delicate and we can't put them in the baggage.
You buy a seat for each of your cellos.
That is correct.
And that is common for many cellists to do these days.
Get the in-flight snack for the cello, too.
Oh, good. So you can double up on those.
Yeah, I mean, bought the seat, might as well get the pretzels, too.
So we were really lucky, though, that we have such great fans. We're based in Pittsburgh, if we didn't mention that, and a lot of our fans helped us out so we could make this dream a reality. You know, we've played in with classical symphonies, dressed up in tuxes and fancy outfits.
You have. You've been the guest artist up in front at a classical music with a symphony orchestra.
Yes, we have. And we limit the headbanging with those shows. And also consider the repertoire. And then we can play in, you know, a venue like the Marlin, and we can, you know, really go crazy and headbang and just really showcase the cello in a different way. But the cello is an accessible instrument. A lot of people really like it, and it's a beautiful instrument. And it kind of crosses that divide between classical listeners and progressive rock listeners.
Well, do not want to let you walk out of these studios without playing a finale for us. And gosh, it's been so fun to hear this live here, Cello Fury. And so what will it be?
We're going to play a piece called Pathos.
Thank you.
Cello Fury, my guests on Alaska Live. You guys keep doing what you're doing and keep recording and touring. This has been great.
Oh, we're super excited. Thank you for having us.
You can find full episodes of Alaska Live TV and download audio podcasts of the Alaska Live radio show online at kuac.org. Alaska Live TV, music and conversation from the KUAC FM studio, is made possible by a grant from Design Alaska, architecture and engineering for the new frontier.